Anyway, so you see that already we identified these two process automata, finance robot, and Musuvathi, which is specification for automation. And in fact, this is the whole function that's not taking any time. So, and this is the foundation of the concept of interest. The fact that we have had multiple structures in the world with multiple as a preventive part, and I think that's the most important. So already there, there was a lot of work. That's why I'm already, already before I had a test of the first. I would now continue to respect. So the second keyword is capability and effect. Strangely, the test of cultural structure for people and individuals. It's called automatic verification method for finite state systems. And it has not only finite systems, but small finite state systems. So the impact is very large, mainly on the foundations. That's over time, logic, the algorithms, basic algorithms, to define what you do that program verification, and developing algorithms that all these very small, very possible finite systems. Already there, we realized the challenges ahead. So, we have a program verification, long scheduling, which was one of the most successful approaches to program verification. It was based on the foundations, but it still recognized the scalability problem. And this is what I'm trying to state for this function that is in what you are mentioning. And then, the fact that we were asking then is whether we could go beyond the notorious automated reportable. And for those of you who are here, if you look at the pictures from that area, this was the standard benchmark. So, every picture will present the method that they have. We apply the method that you think. So, the first thing we were asking was the application is whether we could kind of go beyond the automated reportable. And as we used to do that, the answer would be yes. But the road or the path to go along the lower path is possible. And as I said, the main idea was the foundations are interesting, but we needed to be more pragmatic. So I didn't expect we would sacrifice precision, but the way that keeps the process to work from the practical point of view, this is exactly what the winners of the one this year. This is what they have been doing. So, approximate techniques. Whether over approximation, which means that you over approximate the behavior of the system, under approximation, which means that you hopefully have to do part of the system and maybe sacrifice what is just a method. So, under the responsibility of that, this has been used for this approximation techniques, like abstraction, symbolic methods. Under approximation, we have cluster orders with applications like frequent model checking, testing, systematic testing, and not the least boundary processing to use. And so the winners will tell you more about in the next presentation. And in fact, there has been a combination of these two to make the approximations more customized. And then we have things approaching like CAV and DMT. In fact, if you look at the chart of the world, the previous ones, you see that almost all of them can be classified from one or the other into one of these three categories. So now we just one of the slides on boundary processing, and then I will complete my presentation. So, in fact, if you look at boundary processing, this is based on the fundamental elegant idea, which says that both the lines already with small system parameters. And this fundamental fact is not the only member of the complex matrix. So, for instance, looking at a metric system, we know that the protocol consists of a number of different processes. There are global materials which say that if you can prepare a bus in the system, then you find them are using for about 20 or 30 processes, or 200 or that would be very by the system for a small number of processes, then you conclude from our test for a small number of processes. Now, here, the general contribution, and the point that is the element of process features. So, this I will not tell you about, I will refer to that in a few minutes. But I can just tell you that, instead of this idea that I was simple and powerful idea, I just witnessed by the fact that what we have to develop or that has become both the boundary skills and the scalability from both the fields that I mentioned at the beginning of the presentation. So, as an example, in the presentation of science course, but you are looking at data domains, so you can look from the perspectives, the extension patterns, looking at data domains, and the big memory structures, and the way you have this information, you are finding the resolution, the dynamic control structures, dynamic resolution, concurrent system, etc., etc. If you look at the scalability of the practical application part, you see you have all the that have been developed by the winners, and they have been of extreme importance even in the industrial applications. So, not only that, we have also new paradigms that have been developed based on these principles of powerful ideas, like physical stabilization, unfortunately, I could not answer them because of this question. So, in practice, the way you set to build the consequences because it allows you to put the verification problem of concurrent systems into the verification of the virtual program. But not only that, you can go beyond that. In fact, for instance, in our research on mixed memory models, applying these fundamental ideas, we have been able to reduce the problem not, mixed memory models program in the capabilities of programs are very complicated. But this idea allows us to reduce the problem not only for sequence and cross system behaviors, but all the ways to start to reduce the sequence of problems, which is really amazing. And in fact, there are new approaches that are not published yet to apply these ideas that are produced and perspective of attacks on basic speculation, where you use the number So, before that, the answer to the question is that yes, we can go beyond the data that we talked about, and this is justified by all the schemes that have been developed by the winners. So, in conclusion, this is a simple idea. I feel it has a fundamental meeting task also on the foundations of the practical applications. And it has led to new paradigms that comes to life. And if I just wrote now that I've been following here, it's still very much active. Work with the foundations and the other ones try to do that applications. So, well done, guys, and well deserved. Thank you. So now I invite the readers to come to the stage and receive I don't have the money, unfortunately, but I do need to use that. Okay, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. so many people to start with. We've been following that in the whole customer community. I'm doing this for a few of the patients. This is just a nice slide that I got to do with this. That's why I presented to you today. We're not going to be concerned with this in the community to do this. It's not enough for us to do that. It's not enough for us to do that. When we're trying to get time to do it, you know, but it's not just a different program. As you can see, you know, it's not just steps that are working on the so, now, you know, the rest of the stuff will be told before you. So, let's get back into that. This is an informal that you guys get to see this. And with the other stuff that you get about how to put in the target, you get to set up the operation of the field. Thank you.
and other colleagues, Shaz and I were working on that. And I also want to take this opportunity here to recognize the great help we had from another intern, Major Naik, at the time. He was then a summer intern, now he's a fairly well-known professor. Because together with Major, we were actually independently of this work already starting to
and to the best of our knowledge, we trace this back to chronic or also called chronic product. So for us, in many matters, we have to come to a point of contribution of chronic. So what does this multiplication do? Well, you know, given two matrices, it constructs a bigger matrix. And that matrix is point-wise multiplication of the elements of the two matrices. Right? These are another point. Right? Kind of gives you a bigger matrix when you multiply, when you do a tensor product. And this is the picture. This is the equation that then, as soon as we saw this equation, we knew that we could solve this problem. Now, you know, don't try to understand the equation, but what it says, you know, it's a combination of tensor multiplication and normal multiplication. And the way the insight comes is that, you know, forget all the symbols, just read the A and the B. So if you see the order in which A and B appear on the right hand side of the equation, it is A1, B1, A2, B2. So it's an inclusion of the A's and B's. And what appears on the left side does not have that inclusion anymore. It is A1, A2, B1, B2. So I think, you know, whenever people talk about the beauty of what is that, or beauty of mathematics, you know, I never understood what that meant. But I guess, you know, one way to say it is how much information can you communicate, you know, in a simple equation, you know, we can do just with these 50 seconds. All right. So, you know, that was not the only thing we needed. There were other operations that we needed, in particular, you know, a reduction operation that lets you go back from, that lets you go back from a tensor product to a normal product. But all these other details just completely fell into place. You know, after the insight of, you know, using tensor products, that we have worked out fine. And this idea also composes, right? So there are some equations on this slide, and what that demonstrates to you is that if you want to construct this interleaving between the n weights and the n weights, then you do not need to actually do the interleaving. What you do is, anytime you want to do a commutative strip, instead of doing a normal product, you do a tensor product. Right? So what you have is, you can do n1, tensor n2, tensor n3, tensor n4. Same for the n, the other thread. And then when you multiply them, you apply the other operations, it somehow magically gives you the interleaving of n and n. So this is a result that we published in practice 2008, and I will joint work with Qadeer and Nick, and Fondi is a member of the fund we had coming up with this result. Alright, but this is nothing to do with sequentialization, right? We do have that kind of an idea there, and we're quite happy with this paper, but actually, even though we wrote this, you know, we had a hard time getting the paper accepted. And that was because we didn't have any experiments, right? So, okay, so what's the next step? Well, I was a grad student at that time, you know, to do my PhD, I just thought that this stuff works. So I started out implementing, you know, this tensor products that I'm going to implement a verifier based on this idea. And it turns out it was really very hard. I mean, just to build this thing. But, you know, what helped is that, I was forced to simplify my implementation, forced to figure out a way in which I can get all these tensors work in the right way without actually implementing all of that much movement. And, you know, I was experimenting, I was representing these matrices as BDDs, so the symbolic unit of them as BDDs, and working through the details, a tensor product in that case just turned out to be a concatenation of the BDDs. Right? It was as if I was constructing those BDDs over a program with more variables. So that's where the insight came from, and then, you know, we started simplifying and we figured out, hey, you know, if you just massage our input program a little bit, we don't actually have to do the tensor product. The normal, you know, sequential machines that we have was already kind of going to work on it, right? And this idea was just, you know, thinking of it as, okay, it's a clever way of, you know, it's an implementation detail, right? No one will actually care about it. But it was done that to kind of force me that, there is value to demonstrating the simplicity of certain ideas, and so that's why we have to do that. community for this incredible honor. Thanks for your help. So now I'm ready to switch gears a little bit and then talk about how this idea of complex family helps to create dynamic analysis and systematic testing of critical systems. So before doing that, I want to talk about one key problem that is usually not talked about in knowledge of the perspective.
Real systems are very complicated and messy, and you want to analyze that. And so what you do is you sort of construct a system model and an environment model. So these are abstractions of the real system.
how do you build globally distributed large-scale service that is operated and managed by one person working hard? So I want to say that this particular goal is not to be advanced. And the problem is honestly absolutely critical. So I am working on the infrastructure team inside NASA, and I can have an early hospital for the first team to operate these in terms of statistics. From terms of control, we have been very critical about it on the base of teams. Emphasis on correctness continues to increase, and it's not just because hospitals create stress for the team and for the services. I think it's extremely stressful for the engineers who are on call. And it's a huge disruption to one of the system involved, and it's a huge impediment to innovation. Innovation in building features and improving the product. And focus on this continues to increase for other longer term reasons also. So I learned from Jakob that there are going to be increasing numbers of innovations around data loss and data privacy. So there will be consequences for us in this case around in the there is a lot of emphasis on open services, open systems, which must be required on the security team to interact with it. And so the problem of concurrency might start popping up there. And my experience with seeing how software is developed is that abstraction and tools are unable to keep pace with the complexity of the system. We are aware of concurrent interactions, but the languages and the abstraction that we use for composing these systems, they are geared towards essentially established virtual platforms. So we have to make challenges ahead of us. Perhaps the most important lesson for me that I would like to that I learned in this whole journey that I would like to communicate to you is that modeling should not be hidden. Right? In our quest to claim that we are automatic, we sometimes de-emphasize the importance of modeling. We should not do that because I think it would create an incremental thing that we are in the document. So instead, what we must do is create modeling in this process for me. As an actual activity. In a sense, we can implement the difference between modular specification and programming. And we must somehow enable co-development of modular specification and programming. I conclude with a few concrete questions that I think are interesting. So I think that we could revisit time systems with a lens of context bounded analysis. I'm interpreting the notion of context for individual projects. Right. Why was the time? Well, we all know that time systems were invented to initially deal with the problem of technology between computing and then processing in embedded systems. It turns out that this thing is of renewed importance in distributed systems. In the past, distributed systems were not designed with any kind of communication system. Advances in persistent time protocol, which has been deployed inside the hardware that runs inside data centers. It encourages engineers to build protocols that are correct for this purpose of time devices. The reason they can do it now is that within a data center, because these protocols provide you with time buttons, you can actually depend on them. So I think as a result, investigations that this community has done in the past on the first time systems, it is important and will continue to be really important. I think that on point to development, I think that hardware verification continues to be one of the problems. It is unfortunate that the community has stopped working on hardware verification. We often should revisit the specification of system level hardware, which is an awful thing, but as an integrated system on chip. I think that when I was in graduate school, I don't know, 10,000 instructions, then it